まあ、日常生活の中では片付けみたいなテトリスみたいにうまくこう隙間に入れたりとかっていうところではそういった意味では連想されるっていうことは、そういうふうには思います。
積み重ねていっぺんに消えるようなああいう快感みたいなのが好きで、仕事でもこの運送会社で段ボールを積んだりするんですけど、まあ、そういうの結構こういうゲームって役立つというか、整理整頓に役立つというか。
例えば何だろう、電車の椅子とかに座ってて全員揃ったらなんか一ラインだなみたいな連想することはたまにあるよ。
日常的にもやっぱりやっぱやってた頃はここはこう綺麗にはまるなとか、ここで重なったら綺麗に消えるんだろうなとかいうのはありましたね。
Your brain is really trying to make a fit in reality. This is a thing that our brain does, whether it's trying to put firewood into an optimal stack to fit the space, or food into a cupboard, or people into a train. That is something that our brain is optimized to do. And so it makes sense that people would transform that into an analogy of their everyday life, where they are seeing things in their day-to-day life and imagining items or elements from their life as tetrominoes that they can perhaps manipulate or organize a bit better.
First time I played Tetris, I have an older brother, and already by the time I was born, I had a family member who was really into video games. So, I mean, by the time I even remember playing games at all, there was already Tetris in the house in one shape or another. So I've basically been playing it my entire life. The first Tetris games that I played were on the NES and the Game Boy, but after that, I left for a while and I came back and really got into a game called Tetris Plus. And Tetris Plus was a fun one that I would play. It was on the PlayStation. And in that one, it's actually a little bit of a different Tetris game where you also have this little anthropologist man that you sort of navigate through environments. So the first time I started really seeing the Tetris effect, I would also have this little cartoon professor man who accompanied all of it. And once you start getting to that higher level and spending a lot more time with the game, then you start to just see the shapes everywhere. I mean, a lot of people, I think, see them when they're going to bed. But of course, for me, there was just a whole lot of seeing them everywhere all the time. Whenever I sort of, my mind is free to do whatever it wants, you just sort of have an idle moment and then the shapes start popping into your head. A large part of it is just how recently I've engaged with the game. I do think it's a thing that sort of phases in and out. So if you've been playing a lot of Tetris at the time, recently, I think you're, for me at least, I'm more likely to see it. Whereas if I go away for it a while, you know, that eventually starts to fade as well. And then once you get back into it, it's like it never went away. As far as I can tell, there's no specific trigger for me aside from just playing a whole lot of Tetris.
It's interesting, yeah. I mean, the brain will conform itself to environmental demands, and if you are using your brain in a certain way for long periods of time, it will organize itself to meet that environmental demand. And this individual who is playing for long periods of time is really creating an environmental demand that his brain is trying to meet.
Pier 21 is very unique in a lot of ways. I mean, it's of course not just TGM, they have other games as well, but TGM is sort of, that's its last bastion here in Japan. It's where you have a really big community all in the same place trying to do the same thing. just get better at Tetris, and you've never seen so many Tetris machines in one arcade. I try to make it out there as often as I possibly can. I'm pretty busy at the moment, but I try to get out there every couple of weeks. And being in that environment is really helpful because not only are you, you know, experiencing a game that you love with other people who have the same hobby, but you can also see much better players, you know, working their craft and then, you know, seeing what they're doing differently from you and what you can learn from them.
この仕事始めるようになって、新しいテトリスのシリーズが出て、うちの店でも導入して、一旦すごい人気になったんですけど、やっぱり新しいゲームがどんどん出るんで、下火になって、一回うちの店からもなくなったんですけど、お客さんからもやっぱりあれもう一回やりたいっていう声があって、で、入れたところ、すごくゲームが良かったので、みんなテトリス、やっぱ面白いなってことになって、でだんだんこう熱が上がってきて、でそのうち大会とかもやるようになって、そしたら外からもいっぱい人が来てくれるようになって、そのうちもうどんどん台数も増えて、お店を増やしてテトリスに特化したお店にどんどんどんどんなっていったって感じですかね。
時々夢に出てくることは。正直あります。
夢ならありますけど、夢でブロックでなんか穴なく積んで20個ぐらいがブロック積んでって、そういうのありますけど、
その4つの四角でできたものがなんか勝手に落ちてきたりとか動いたりするような体験をようなその光景を頭の中に思い描いたりします。
荷物詰めてる時とかに箱の中に物を入れる時に綺麗にピタッと揃うとなんかライン揃ったな、気持ちいいなみたいな感じで、あとそれくらいかな感じるのは。あと特には日常で何かっていうのは別に感じたりとかしないですね。
世に言われてるようなテトリス効果で、そのビルがそう見えてしまうとかっていうのは、ひょっとしたらテトリスを一番最初にプレイした時に、高校生とかそれぐらいの時に、ひょっとしたらその記憶の中でちょっとそういうふうに感じたことはあるかなっていう気がするのと、当時そういう話をしたのを覚えてるので、それは多分僕にもありましたけど。
I like to think that it works the same way as an athlete going into the zone. If you're playing basketball or playing tennis or something, you go into the zone and your body is playing that game. You're not thinking. Your reaction time is much faster than you can actually think. And then your body is doing its thing. And so I think that being in the zone is, you could say it's a pleasure center. But it's something good, just like meditation, and so I believe that Tetris can have that same effect.
多分僕だけかもしれないんですけど、ジョギングし終わって家に帰ってきた時の感覚とテトリスをプレイし終わった後の感覚が近いですかね。なんか気分、両方とも気分は同じような、ちょっとこう解放された感じになっているのはいつも近いなと思う時がありましたね。一時期両方ともジョギングもテトリスも同時にやってる時があって、なんか他の人はなんつったっけな、音楽聴いてるのに近いって言った人もいるし、いろんな多分感想があると思うんですけど、僕はジョギング終わった時の感覚に近かったし、今でもそれはちょっと変わんないかなっていう感じがしますね。
The zone, I think, is Tetris is a game that is sort of uniquely suited to putting people in that mental state, I think, because the rules are set, everybody knows what they are. It's a game that's so simple that anybody can understand it. And since it's engaging in that way, where it immediately brings you in, I think it really just, it puts you into that same state that you get when you're very much focused on any other activity. Of course, it could be running. In my case, I do a lot of weightlifting. And I think a lot of people, even just in their own work, they can get into these mental states that are very rewarding once you get out of them, knowing that you did well in them.
It's like being in flow situation where you don't even hardly have to think about playing the game. It just happens naturally, like riding a bicycle. You can do it without hardly thinking at all. It is so natural to move the tetrominos around into place that it seems effortless to your brain because you have it optimized in your neural network.
You get to experience a couple of very interesting things when you play Tetris. One is that, of course, as you get better at it, you can build something. So, I mean, you have these seven pieces and you can use them to create, ideally, something that is, you know, nice and clean and proper and stacked well. But you can also use it to create something chaotic. And then you also get to experience afterwards that feeling of using those same pieces to then take it down and clear everything away. And I think you get, it really sort of gets you into a mindset that allows you to look at things in different ways. You can, what can you do with these pieces that you have? And I think in the sense of applying that to a creative process, you can look at, you know, what is at your disposal. You have art supplies or you have building materials. What can you do with these things? And I think sort of in that way, it is a game that sort of allows you to leverage that same creative aspect.
プレイステーション。